The challenges of shooting in an iconic place is, as you can probably tell by my breathing, it's a long way up. It's 2,000 metres from our base camp to the summit. We came up here, we did surveys several times creatively with all directors, producers, writers. Then we decide on what we're actually going to shoot up here, what part of the construction of the scenes or the particular script we're going to shoot up here. Then we come back and we look at the logistics side of shooting here. We are actually, as we speak, shooting up in the summit. So to get equipment up there is very difficult. We have small off-road vehicles that can come up the path. However, we only get 3/4 of the way up, and we have to carry every piece of equipment by hand the last quarter. Up here, approximately between 110 and 120 people, including cast. That enhances our crew, our normal shooting crew, by about 1/4, just for muscle power more than anything. It's fantastic to be able to shoot here. I mean, we're blessed that we're actually allowed to shoot here. So we thank everyone here to help us get here. But every crew member of this show was excited about getting to this particular plot, because this is it. This is where it all happens. Picnic at Hanging Rock, we're standing on Hanging Rock as it is. It's the iconic location. It would have been a disaster if we hadn't got there. And we're here. The advantage of shooting Picnic at Hanging Rock in Victoria and Melbourne was mainly locations. Melbourne and Victoria have possibly some of the best 19th century architecture in Australia, if not the world. And Hanging Rock was obviously going to be a major part of this show, no matter what happened. And it was fantastic to go up there. I think we've already discussed in an earlier discussion about the logistics of Hanging Rock. However, it was just an iconic, obviously we had to be there for obvious reasons. But we utilised a lot of other locations while we were up there. We did the picnic around the Sanatorium Lake up on Mount Macedon, which was just spectacular. We did a lot of shooting there, i.e. bringing horse and carts down roads, etc., so we can get that iconic 18th century, 19th century look that we're obviously is difficult to find in the city. And it's just a beautiful area to shoot. The people were fantastic. The locations were amazing, and they're not that far out of Melbourne. Clunes was my first thought. The first time I read the script, I said, it's got to be Clunes. Clunes has been used in other films prior to us, obviously, over the years. It's a fantastic 19th century town that hasn't really been touched for many years. The main street is almost exactly what it was 100 years ago, 150 years ago. So it was the right choice. We went to many other towns around Victoria to eliminate, just in case there was something slightly better, but we obviously went back to Clunes. Now, Clunes Main Street, as I said, is very similar to what it would have been 150 years ago, so it was perfect. We had to cover the road with dirt, obviously, and change a few things and get rid of a few modern things. And we'll do some of this. We did some of it practically, but we'll also do some of it visual effects wise. But the minute we walked in there, we stood in the middle of the town. It was the place to be. The people of Clunes were fantastic, because obviously we closed down the main street for a couple of days, which is always annoying for the locals, but they supported us no end. And it was just a pleasure to work there. We had beautiful weather, and the town was just spectacularly supportive. Werribee Mansion was probably one of our main locations. Werribee and Labasa were our two big locations. Werribee doubled for the exterior of the college, the school. They have a wonderful rose garden, which I believe is one of the biggest in the Southern Hemisphere, which we utilised, and spectacular location. I believe that Victoria has the most diverse locations close to the city and outside in the regional areas, better than anywhere else in Australia. So the choice of bringing Picnic here was very easy. As I mentioned before, because of the 19th century wonderful architecture they have here, the great iconic landscape and the Macedon area, and Listerfield, and also the obvious Hanging Rock. So the choice of bringing Picnic here was easy, as I find with a lot of other shows that I worked on.
The most memorable scenes, for me, I think I have two. One is this beautiful scene with me and Maddie and Lily and the three of us girls. We've stolen some alcohol and we're sort of like cheekily talking to each other and just playing dress ups and fooling around with each other. And it was really beautiful because you do see that heart and the fact that these girls really do take care of each other. And I think that's really important. And it was just so much fun to do that. And there was a scene that James and I did in the stables where Irma's sort of at one of her lowest points. And it was, I think it was like the second or third day we were shooting, and it was just such a beautiful scene with James. And I hadn't worked with him before, and our characters hadn't met either, so that was really lovely for us to, you know, organically and realistically figure each other's characters out.
Albert riding up to look for Mike, and he kind of gallops in and he ties his horse up and he sees Mike's horse, which is a French Clydesdale, this big beautiful white horse, and he comes running in through the bush and he jumps over this log, and I come up and just catch it and tie it up and then take off, and it's two big animals, beautiful. It was just after it, I was buzzing, it was really, really cool.
I think one of the most memorable moments would be out in Macedon. I think the moment when we all arrived on set in the white picnic dresses for the first time, and I think, you know, everyone's so close, the whole creative team on Picnic, and I think it was a beautiful moment for the crew and cast and everyone to just see that image and the whole thing sort of just centered and sort of remembering this, you know, because you're so knee deep and all, you're just seeing one foot in front of the other throughout the whole shoot. And I think it was definitely a moment where everything kind of came together, and I think everyone really could see the vision so clearly, and it was really inspiring, I think, and exciting.
To be honest, I don't think I do have a favourite day or memory, and that's because it's just been an amazing experience, and that's not like a Miss Universe answer. I genuinely feel like this has been one of the most unique jobs I've had, and creatively it's been so fulfilling and enriching that it's quite strange to think about an ending. It feels like it's been 2 years at the same time as it feels like it's been 2 days. It's been a very interesting shoot.
There was a moment where we were down in Macedon, and it was like 8 degrees and everyone had gastro and we were all wearing our white dresses, and that was a real low point. At the time of shooting that, but on reflection, we just all laugh about it, and it was, I think, it was the best and the worst times, yeah.
It was something else. It was 2 degrees, 3 degrees, something like that. White dresses, corsets, port-a-loo, like mud, leeches.
I was not involved in the gastro. I was not on the rock, and I did not get gastro. And in some ways, I'm sad I was not there because the stories sound very funny.
So we've all come up with a theory of that. We were all purging before we were allowed to go onto the rock. This is how we're accepting the situation of gastro and leeches and 3 degrees.
I was patient zero. Yeah, so I came to work and wasn't feeling too good, and I was actually up on the cart that you will see, I'm sure, in this. I was up on the cart and just sitting there for 12 hours with a corset on, just like bumping up and down in the hot, and it was just so bad. Every single person in the cast and crew got terrible gastro. So we were shooting in big white dresses, trying not to make them into brown dresses, if you get my drift. So that was fun. Oi, that was bad. I just remember seeing people that just the ripple effect, slowly everyone was getting sick, and I was like, I'm so sorry, everybody, oh my God.
But yeah, so that would have been definitely the hardest week. Having my hair tied to Samara's and me gagging and her stomach rolling over, it brought us all very close. I think think for me personally, I am always going to choose the magical elements.
I think what happened to the girls is what happened in the final chapter of the book. So there was a final chapter that only got released after Joan Lindsay had passed away, the 18th chapter.
But yeah, I think they went to the rock, they went up there, and they jumped into another dimension. Have you read the final chapter?
And in that, the girls go up to the rock and Ms. McCraw follows them. And she turns into this like crazy crab witch lady and like opens this like dimension time portal. And she's like, follow me, girls. And Miranda and Marion follow her in, and Irma hesitates. And then the portal closes.
Oh, it's incredible. The guts to it, and that, which is why, you know, Joan Lindsay didn't add that. The publishers didn't think it was necessary, that it was suitable. And I love so much the fact that our show runs with that energy of the last chapter.
And so that's what I believe happened, because it's so cool. It's so eccentric.
Some of your companions have managed to lose themselves. We've escaped.
Something terrible has happened.
Here it is then, retribution.
They stopped searching.
Shocking. It's been a week.
Where are they?
The girls are gone. Missing. Presumed dead.